Ladies and gentlemen, good morning and a warm welcome to the prestigious Mangalya Convention Center, Swami Vivekanand Subharti University. Today we all have gathered here for a truly special occasion of international guest lecture featuring His Excellency Lee Cheol-woo, Honorable Governor of Gyeongsangbuk-do, South Korea, and the MOU signing ceremony. Please welcome our guests with a round of applause. His Excellency Lee Cheol-woo, Governor of Gyeongsangbuk-do, South Korea, along with Dr. Stuti Narayan Kakkarji, Chancellor Swami Vivekanand Subharti University, Vice Chancellor Sir, Major General G.K. Thapalyalji, and the Korean delegation. Thank you very much, Dr. Hirohitoji, for setting up the dais for us. And before we start today's ceremony, I would like to request our esteemed guests, along with Vice Chancellor Sir and Chancellor Ma'am, to come forward for lamp lighting.
Namo tassa bhagavato arahato sammasambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato sammasambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato sammasambuddhassa. Iti piso bhagava arahang samma sambuddho vijja charana sampanno sugato lokavidu anuttaro purisa dhamma sarati sattha deva manusana Buddho Bhagavati Savakato Bhagavata Dhammo Sandhittiko Akaliko Yehipasiko Opanayiko Pachatang Veditabho Viyuhiti Supatipanno Bhagavato Savaka Sangho Ujupatipanno Bhagavato Savaka Sangho Yaya Patipanno Bhagavato Savaka Sangho Samichi Patipanno Bhagavato Savaka Sangho Yadida Chattari Purisa Yugani Atha Purisa Pugala Esa Bhagavato Savaka Sangho Ahunayo Pahunayo Dakhinayo Anjali Karaniyo Anuttara Puyankheta Lokasati Sadhu, Sadhu, Sadhu.
Thank you very much, Bhanteji. Ladies and gents, please take your seat. Before we proceed further, I would like to take a moment to acknowledge the presence of our distinguished guests. And to do the honors, I would like to request Honorable Chancellor Ma'am, Honorable Vice Chancellor Sir, along with Dr. Hirohito Sir, to come forward and offer a planter and scarf to our esteemed guests. I would request you to have a round of applause to welcome our esteemed guest, Mr. Lee Yang-seong. Thank you very much. Now We will proceed with the program and commence with the welcome address. I invite Major General Dr. G.K. Thapalyal, Honorable Vice Chancellor of Swami Vivekanand Subharti University, to deliver the welcome address. His words will set the tone of this enlightening event.
His Excellency Lee Cheol-woo, Honorable Governor of Gyeongsangbuk-do, South Korea, all distinguished members of the delegation from Republic of Korea, invited guests, head of institutions, Honorable Chancellor Swami Vivekanand Subharti University, all faculty members, persons from media, and my dear students. Indeed, it's a great honor for me to stand before you and extend a warm welcome to our honorable guest, His Excellency, the Governor of Gyeongsangbuk-do, who has been very gracious and kindly accepted our invitations to be here with us this morning at Subharti campus. I extend a warm welcome to all of you and thank Excellency for his gracious presence during this event. Thank you very much. Honorable Governor, sir, we know your love for India and love for Indian people. That is the reason that you made this visit possible here. First, we have seen you going to different places and visiting different higher education institutions that includes Delhi University, Jawaharlal Nehru University, Delhi, and visiting our UP capital, Lucknow, and signing MOU with government of Uttar Pradesh. It is very clear that you want how the collaboration between India and Korea will benefit the people of both countries. India and Korea friendship is long, very long, and particularly it's on the completing 50th year of friendship. We have come a long way. From the old history of Indo-Korean friendship or old Indo-Korean relationship to Indo-Korean friendship, it's becoming greater and greater. And to strengthen that friendship, you have shown a great championship towards this friendship. Particularly Subharti University, I would like to say a few things. The Subharti University is multidisciplinary, research-driven university. Our focus is now in innovation and research, particularly which can be collaborated with University of Korea, are in the field of integrated medicine. When our team visited Gyeongbuk in last year, we came across the potential between this collaboration. When our traditional medicine like Ayurveda, naturopathy, and other traditional medicine combined with the traditional medicine of South Korea and along with the modern medicine, we probably will be able to give complete holistic health to our citizens. In this field, we look forward to collaborate with the universities of South Korea, with the organizations which are working towards the holistic medicine. The Subharti will be very happy and will be delighted to collaborate in these areas. Another areas we would like to collaborate with you in the field of culture, Indo-Korean culture. We saw the glimpses of Indo-Korean culture last evening in Delhi. And I thank you, Your Excellency, for having invited us to witness that Indo culture, a glimpses of Indo culture, and during for the dinner you gave us in our honor. I thank you once again for this gracious presence of yours in the Subharti campus, and we look forward for our friendship between Subharti and between your province will take newer heights and will are to benefit our society in both the countries. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.
Thank you very much, sir. Continuing our program, we'll have an introduction of our esteemed guest, His Excellency Lee Cheol-woo, Honorable Governor of Gyeongsangbuk-do, South Korea. His introduction will shed light on his remarkable achievements and contribution as Governor Lee. And to read his introduction, I would like to invite Dr. Seema Sharma, Associate Professor, Samrat Ashok Subharti School of Buddhist Studies.
Dhanyavad Pallavi. Jai Hind. Ani Haseyo. Atithi Devo Bhava. Bharatiya Sanskriti mein Atithi ka mahatva ingit karne wala yah sutra hai. Bharatiya Sanskriti ki isi bhavna ke saath main Subharti Vishwavidyalaya parivar ki or se आज के कार्यक्रम के मुख्य अतिथि का परिचय आप सबके समक्ष प्रस्तुत कर रही हूँ। आज के कार्यक्रम के मुख्य अतिथि माननीय ली चेओल वो उत्तरी कोरिया के गवर्नर हैं। आप नेशनल असेंबली के पूर्व सदस्य रहे हैं और जनवरी 2005 से 2008 तक उत्तरी ग्योंगसांग प्रांत के उप गवर्नर रह चुके हैं। वर्तमान में उत्तरी ग्योंगसांग प्रांत के आप गवर्नर हैं। माननीय ली का जन्म 15 अगस्त 1955 को हुआ, ग्योंगसांगबुक-डो में हुआ। उन्होंने ग्योंगसांगबुक नेशनल यूनिवर्सिटी में पढ़ाई की और गणित विषय में शिक्षा में आपने महारत हासिल की। उन्होंने योनसोई विश्वविद्यालय में ग्रेजुएट स्कूल ऑफ पब्लिक एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन से स्नातक भी किया। अगस्त 2007 में डेगू विश्वविद्यालय द्वारा आपकी अद्भुत उपलब्धियों और योग्यताओं और विद्वत्ता के लिए बिजनेस एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन में पीएचडी की उपाधि से मानद उपाधि से भी सम्मानित किया गया। इसके अतिरिक्त 2013 में आपको शिक्षा विभाग क्योंगपुक राष्ट्रीय विश्वविद्यालय द्वारा भी मानद राष्ट्रीय पीएचडी की उपाधि प्रदान की गई। माननीय ली चेओल-वू उप गवर्नर बनने से पहले 20 वर्ष से अधिक तक राष्ट्रीय खुफिया सेवा के सदस्य और प्रबंधक के रूप में कार्य कर चुके हैं। एनआईएस में शामिल होने से पूर्व आपने कुछ मध्य विद्यालयों में शिक्षक के रूप में भी महत्वपूर्ण कार्य किया है। आप नेशनल असेंबली में खुफिया समिति, शिक्षा विज्ञान और प्रौद्योगिक समिति, बजट और लेखा समिति के विशेष सदस्य हैं। श्री ली को अब तक अनेक सम्मानों से भी अलंकृत किया गया है। उनकी कई विशिष्ट उपलब्धियां हैं, जिनमें से कुछ महत्वपूर्ण पुरस्कारों की चर्चा मैं यहां पर कर रही हूं। ऑनर ऑफ होंग्यो ज्यूंग योंग। इसके अतिरिक्त प्रशासनिक विकास हेतु प्राउड कोरियन अवार्ड, कोरियन वोटर अवार्ड, कोरियन वॉलेंटियर शेयरिंग अवार्ड आदि कई महत्वपूर्ण पुरस्कार आप प्राप्त कर चुके हैं। अब तक आपकी अनेक पुस्तकें भी प्रकाशित हैं, जिनमें से कुछ प्रमुख की चर्चा मैं यहाँ पर कर रही हूँ। डोंट गो टू वर्क, द आंसर इन द फील्ड, कंट्री साइड डेवलपमेंट लीड टू नेशनल डेवलपमेंट, चेंज टू सर्वाइव। भारतवर्ष के प्रमुख शैक्षणिक संस्थान सुभारती विश्वविद्यालय, जहाँ का ध्येय वाक्य है सेवा संस्कार राष्ट्रीयता, शिक्षा सेवा संस्कार और राष्ट्रीयता, इस विश्वविद्यालय परिसर में मैं आपका पुनः स्वागत और अभिनंदन कर रही हूँ। सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिनः के मंत्र के साथ आपका पुनः पुनः स्वागत है सर। वेलकम इन Subharti।
सो द मच अवेटेड मोमेंट हैज अराइव्ड एंड वी लिसन टू हिज एक्सेलेंसी नाउ ऑन द टॉपिक एजुकेशनल प्रोग्रेशन एंड एम्प्लॉयमेंट अपॉर्चुनिटीज इन ग्योंगसांगबुक-डो साउथ कोरिया। and we eagerly anticipate his insight and valuable knowledge on the subject, which holds significant importance for students and professionals alike. Over to you, sir.
Namaste. Mera naam Lee Cheol-woo hai. Me Gyeongsangbuk-do ka governor hung. Muje amnogse milke ol. Subharti University me lecture taker. Po kushi ho lahe. Meri Hindi. Meri Hindi samajik kaya hunke. Dan yeada. Okay?
Kamsa.
Thank you. Hi, every day. I am honored and proud to have the opportunity of giving my special lecture in Swarati University. My name is Lee Cheol-woo, Governor of Gyeongsangbuk-do, Republic of Korea. I am happy to share my thoughts and insights with you, especially the young minds who hold the key to the future of this great country, India. Today, I'll introduce of Korea, especially the advantages that we have. India has the world's number one population in 2023. India is a great country in many aspects. First, congratulations on being the host of the G20 forum this year. India assumed the presidency of the G20 forum last year as responsible members. Both Korea and India play very important roles, make significant contributions to the international community. Starting with diplomatic relations in 1973, our two countries' relationship have been very active. Friday last week, our two countries' heads of state met before G7's meeting. India, Modi Prime Minister, Korea President Yoon Suk-yeol. This year, our diplomatic to celebrate 50 years of Golden Jubilee. In the area of culture, Korea and India have many common aspects. I heard that the act of saran sparsh is deeply rooted in Indian traditions and is a way of expressing respect to the elderly for their wisdom, humanity, and honor by touching the feet. Similarly, in Korea, we give a New Year's bow, sebe in Korean, by rolling our head to the elderly, especially to parents during the Korean New Year, in order to show our respect and wishes for the upcoming year. We both have a beautiful tradition of respecting for elders. Work big data, text analysis show K-pop, K-drama, K-food, K-beauty, Hangul, semiconductor, and so on. All these keywords show Korean wave. You may be a fan of K-pop stars. You know BTS well. I think, although BTS is more famous than me, I am honored to visit Subharti University before BTS. You know Subharti University, okay? You may dance for size song, Gangnam Style, you know? Now on, I am going to talk about Korea in Gyeongsangbuk-do. 오늘 now I'll tell you about the opportunity for you. I dare to say that India is young, not in terms of history and culture, but simply the average age of the population. The median age is slightly over 32 years old. Korea, 45 years. I think youth is an opportunity, so Indians have a greater opportunity. As I know, India first invented the numbers zero. Based on this, I can see that Indians are good at mathematics. Therefore, I think Indian is so excellent. Did you know that I was a mathematics teacher when I was young? Okay? I was a mathematics teacher. Indians have many great people in mathematics, in business, in IT, and so on. I believe that Gyeongsangbuk-do could be the best place for you to study, research, and work for your successes. In Gyeongsangbuk-do, there are many universities. These universities show their strong interest in the exchange of students, STEM, academic research, joint project, and so on. In Gyeongsangbuk-do, we provide many types of support for safe settlement through Korean language education, university education, employment, and settlement programs in order to help universities' cooperation and exchanges across national borders. International student policy in our province is highly conducive. To make easy human exchange, Gyeongsangbuk-do has implemented a regional specialization visa and is in the process of introducing a wider area visa. These initiatives aim to support your kids studying abroad in Gyeongsangbuk-do, facilitating employment opportunities and help families in working in Korea. Please come to Gyeongsangbuk-do to accomplish new type of gold rush in the 21st century, the K-dream. A big opportunity is opening up for you in Gyeongsangbuk-do. Thank you very much for your patience and attention to my lecture. I hope it was not boring at all, paving for you a highway to deep meditation and seeing the Buddha. Once again, thank you for having me here today. Thank you. 감사합니다. Namaste, Meranam, Icharuhe, Me Gyeongsangbuk-do-ga, Gabeonhoeum, Muje Akkoro, Se, Milke Ol, Swarovati University, Me Next Delkul, O Kususu Ho Lahe.
Thank you so much for such an enlightening talk, and I'm sure a lot of students will look forward for their career in Gyeongsangbuk-do. Thank you very much. Now I would like to invite Mr. Koo Yun Cheol, former Central Minister, Republic of Korea, for delivering a short speech. Please, sir.
Namaste. Good morning, everybody. Yeah. My name is Yun Cheol-woo, and I was the former Minister for Government Policy Coordination. Right now, I'm working at the Gyeongbuk Art and Culture Foundations. I'm now working with Governor Cheol-woo Lee. Anyway, this is my first visit, but I found that India is very powerful potential countries, especially in the area of cultures. Thank you. As you know well, Korea is well developed in the area of a digital economy, especially semiconductor and secondary battery and solar panel cars. You know the Hyundai cars and electronics. So, but the problem of Korea is that we short of populations in the area of manufacturing companies. So if you visit Korea or if you have studied in Korea, probably you will have decent jobs in Korea, especially in the area of semiconductor, car, electronics, and secondary batteries. So if you have interest in studying or working in Korea, why don't visit Gyeongsangbuk-do? Gyeongsangbuk-do has a lot of manufacturing companies, Samsung, LG, POSCO, steel company is located in Gyeongsangbuk-do. I would like to recommend you to visit Korea and learn Korea. It will help Indian economy and it will help Korean economy. I want to see you in Gyeongsangbuk-do and welcome all of you to visit Korea. Thank you. Thank you very much.
And the very precious moment of MOU signing has arrived. Now we'll witness the significant moment. And to do the honors, I would like to request His Excellency to come forward on the right-hand side of the dais, and our respected registrar, sir, Mr. D.K. Saxena ji, to come on the left side of the dais. Thank you very much. This formal agreement will strengthen the bond between Swami Vivekanand Subharti University and Gyeongsangbuk-do, South Korea, for fostering the educational and cultural collaborations. Thank you very much. And now it's time for the presidential address. We have our distinctive honorable guest, no, not guest, our honorable vice chancellor ma'am, Mrs. Stuti Narayan Kakkarji, who will deliver the presidential address. Her guidance and support have been instrumental in making this event a reality, and we eagerly look forward to her words of wisdom.
Namaskar. Good morning, everybody. Sir, welcome, Your Excellency and your entire team. Welcome to Subharti University. We are situated in Meerut in Uttar Pradesh, which is a province of India. Yes, day before you signed an MOU with our state government, and so thank you very much for it, and thank you very much for your MOU with us. You see, as I told you, I have worked in Uttar Pradesh for almost 40 years. And when I was in culture department, I was we discovered our ancient ties with Korea, of Uttar Pradesh's ancient ties with Korea, very specific to us. There is a princess of Ayodhya. It used to be called Ayukta, who traveled to Korea to married the prince there. Her name was Suri Ratna, and she was the daughter of King Padmasen and Indumati, who ruled the ancient kingdom of Kosala, whose capital was capital was Ayodhya. The marriage of Suri Ratna with King Suro of Goemgwan Gaya, as mentioned by Samyuk Yusa, a 13th century Korean chronicle, is very romantic. She heard a voice from the heavens telling her that she must travel to Korea and meet the King Suro and marry him. Her Korean name is Hyo Hong-up. I'm sorry, I'm getting the pronunciation wrong. The union proved very fruitful, and today 6 million Koreans trace their lineage to the legendary queen as direct descendants of her 12 children with King Suro. A passage in Samyuk Yusa indicates that King Jilbi built a Buddhist temple for the ancestral queen Hyo to mark the spot where she and King Suro were married. So, it's not only India and Korea that have ties. We have these ties of marriage. Uttar Pradesh, Ayodhya, where Lord Ram was born. Ayodhya is a very important place for us. It is for Hinduism, Buddhism, Jainism, and of course the birthplace of Lord Ram, and whom we all worship in this part of the in India. Then they say there are also stones she carried with her while she was traveling to calm waters and all, river waters, sea waters, and those stones are still present in her tomb in Korea. The place is Grimmi. I'm not getting the pronunciation right, but that's where it is. I think it's very close to your province, sir. And the Kim family, I was asking, Kim family, you know, they say they are related, they have direct lineage to her. Personally, for me, Ayodhya also is very close to my heart, because my great grandfather, he wrote a book on Ayodhya, and he always was emotionally attached to Ayodhya ji. And we belong to Allahabad, and we used to travel to Ayodhya ji to worship in the temples that are there. Sir, on behalf of Subharti University, I assure you that we will do our best, put in all efforts, that the MOU that we have signed on today is a vibrant and fruitful MOU, which will lead to greater cooperation between the two partners. Sir, we need your expertise. As you had pointed out yesterday, Korea was a very poor country. We are also a poor country, but Korea has moved ahead. While we have sort of remained, we are trying, we are doing our best, but probably because of the size or whatever is the reason that we have not done so well, sir. And therefore, your expertise, your experience of turning around the economy will be very useful for us, sir. And I'm sure that this MOU will be a win-win situation for both of us. Sir, I wish you and your team personal good health and happiness. And I hope you carry good memories of your visit to this university, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you very much, ma'am. We are coming towards the end of the program now, and to express our appreciation and gratitude, we'll present the mementos and souvenirs to His Excellency. And these tokens will symbolize our admiration for His presence and the knowledge he imparted. And to do the honors, I would like to request Honorable Chancellor Ma'am, Honorable Vice Chancellor Sir, and Dr. Hirohito Sir to come forward at the front of the stage along with Governor Lee. First we'll play the national anthem of South Korea, and the later would be the national anthem of India. So please be at your place.
모두 자리에서 일어나 주시기 바랍니다.
Please be at your place for both the national anthems. Thank you very much.
Jaya Gatha Jana Gana Mangala Daya नायक जय हे भारत भाग्य विधाता जय हे जय हे जय हे जय 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 हे